Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 13 different ways that you can put your Mac to sleep. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, when it comes to putting your Mac to sleep, it really depends on which model you have. Much older Macs are going to have two different sleep modes, display sleep and full computer sleep. But more recent Macs, especially if they're from the last few years and running macOS Big Sur, just have one type of sleep. That's usually called display sleep. And there's really no difference between display sleep and actual computer sleep. In some cases, they both happen at the same time. And in other cases, your computer goes to sleep a few seconds after the display goes to sleep. It really doesn't matter for all practical purposes. You can just think of it as putting your Mac to sleep. So let's start with some of the most obvious methods for doing this. Of course, at any time you can go to the Apple menu and there's a command for sleep. Also, if you're on a MacBook, you can of course close the lid on your MacBook. That puts it to sleep. Now, how about a keyboard shortcut for doing this? Well, there are actually two, but they don't work on the newest Macs. The two keyboard shortcuts are either Command Option and then the Eject key. On some keyboards, it's a power key. Now, this doesn't work on Macs that have Touch ID. With Touch ID, the Touch ID sensor acts as the power button, and the shortcut won't work with that particular type of power button. But if you have an older Mac or a Mac with an external keyboard, and you've got either Eject key or a power button kind of in the upper right-hand corner that's not Touch ID, then Command Option and that Eject button will put your Mac to sleep. Also, you can use Control and Shift and the Eject button to put your Mac to sleep. In the old days, Option Command and Eject would put your computer to sleep and Control Shift Eject would be display sleep. But since they're the same thing now, either one of those keyboard commands works. So if you have a MacBook Pro, if you have Touch ID, that means you also have the Touch Bar. And you can actually add a button for sleep to the Touch Bar. So to do that, go to System Preferences, and then Keyboard, and then look for Customize Control Strip in the Keyboard section. Now you have all these extra buttons that you can add to the Control Strip in the Touch Bar. And one of them right here is Sleep. So you can add that one to the Touch Bar, and then you've got a button that's conveniently there to put your Mac to sleep. Well, what if you have a Mac that has Touch ID but doesn't have the Touch Bar, like a MacBook Air or one of the new iMacs? It doesn't seem like there's a way to put your Mac to sleep using just the keyboard, but there are actually two different solutions. One is to lock the screen first. If you go to the Apple menu, you'll see Lock Screen is Control Command Q. You could also press the Touch ID power button with a finger that isn't one of the ones you've registered with Touch ID. Doing that, just a quick press on it, will go to the lock screen. And then when you're on the lock screen, no matter what method you use to get there, even if you use, say, fast user switching and then login window, if you get to the login window, quickly tapping the escape key on your keyboard will put your Mac to sleep. You could also set your own keyboard shortcut, and I'll show you that in a few minutes. Now, a method that works on a lot of Macs, like iMacs, my Mac Pro, maybe some older MacBooks that have a traditional power button, is you can press and hold the power button for 1.5 seconds. Do it for too much longer and you're actually going to force your Mac to shut down. But just 1.5 seconds will actually put your Mac to sleep. You have to press and hold for 1.5 seconds and then release, and then your Mac should go to sleep. Now, one method, of course, we need to mention is the automatic sleep. If you go into System Preferences and then you go either to Energy Saver, if you've got a Mac that's plugged in like an iMac, or if you have a Mac that's using a battery, this will not be Energy Saver but battery instead. You go in there and you have Turn Display Off After, and this is basically sleep. So you set this to whatever time it is, and that's pretty much an automatic sleep when the display goes off. Now, another thing you could do is set a hot corner to go to sleep. To set hot corners, go to System Preferences, and then go to Mission Control, and then look for the Hot Corners button here. Now, you've got four corners on your screen, so you can choose one of them, say the bottom right corner, to put display to sleep. And if you select that and then move your cursor down to the bottom right hand corner, your Mac will go to sleep. Since the bottom right hand corner is sort of like an absolute destination, you can basically just swipe on your trackpad to the bottom right hand corner or quickly move your mouse there. It's a quick action. It's impossible to miss the bottom right hand corner, so it's really easy to put your display to sleep. And if you want to put that with a modifier key, you can do that. simply go to select it but hold a modifier key like command down and you'll see it puts command there, put display to sleep. So now I have to hold the command key down to use the hot corner. Now another thing you can do is have Siri put your Mac to sleep. So just activate Siri the way you normally would. In this case I'm going to use the menu bar here, but you could use a keyboard shortcut or you could voice activate Siri and then just ask Siri to go to sleep. Go to sleep.
Okay, going to sleep.
Another way to do it with your voice is if you're using the accessibility voice control functions. So in System Preferences you can go to Accessibility and then go to Voice Control. And you may already be using this for dictation or other things. If you have it enabled, one of the commands here is sleep. And you can see you could ask your Mac to go to sleep or say go to sleep Mac and it will put your Mac to sleep with voice control. Now whenever I do a video like this people always seem to ask me, is there a way to do it in Terminal? And there is. You can use the shutdown command to actually put your Mac to sleep. Shutdown can also shut down your Mac, of course. Now you're going to need the super user access. So you're going to have to start with sudo and then use shutdown. Now you don't want to shut down, so you want to do -s for sleep. And then you have to provide a time. So now we'll do it right now. But you could do +1 to do it in 1 minute or +5 to do it in 5 minutes, things like that. And then if I do that, it's going to prompt me for my password. And this of course is really useful if you're writing shell scripts and you want to have your Mac go to sleep when the shell script is done running. You might be using sudo to activate the entire shell script anyway, so then you don't need to add it to the shutdown command and you can have a sleep command at the end of your shell script. Well, if you can do it in Terminal, what about in Automator? So there isn't a built-in action for doing this in Automator, but you can do it using AppleScript. So I'm going to create a new application here and I'm going to use AppleScript as the only action. And all I need to do is to tell application and I'm going to use Finder here to sleep. And that's all you need to do here. And I could save this as an app. So for instance, I could put this in my applications folder, in my user folder, not the system applications folder. I can call it sleep. And then I can use the application here to simply put my Mac to sleep. But I could also drag and drop to add that to the dock. So now I have an icon in the dock that'll put my Mac to sleep. And of course you can also use that to extend any Automator workflow you want. So if you have an Automator workflow that takes several minutes to run, you could add this to the end of it to automatically put your Mac to sleep when it's done. Now I mentioned that there is a way to set your own keyboard shortcut for sleep. Very handy if you've got a Touch ID Mac and you really just want a straightforward keyboard shortcut for this. So notice in the Apple menu it's just the command sleep here with no keyboard shortcut. Well, you can set a shortcut for any menu command. So let's do exactly that. Let's go to System Preferences and then Keyboard and then Shortcuts and then go to App Shortcuts and I'm going to hit the plus button here. Keep all applications. Set the menu title to sleep and the keyboard shortcut to something that won't be used by anything else. I'm going to use Command Control and then the down arrow and then add that. And now when I look at the Apple menu, notice sleep has a keyboard shortcut that I could easily use to put my Mac to sleep. So there's a whole bunch of different methods for putting your Mac to sleep. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.